दोस्तों, सोशियोलॉजी के टॉपर्स के मुंह से तो आपने बहुत बार सुना होगा कि उन्होंने स्लीपी के रिसोर्सेज यूज किए, तो लेकिन ऐसे भी कुछ टॉपर्स हैं जो सोशो ऑप्शनल से नहीं है, वो क्यों स्लीपी का नाम लेते हैं? दोस्तों, हम स्लीपी क्लासेस में जीएस एक्सटेंसिवली कवर करते हैं। ना सिर्फ यूट्यूब में डेली 4 वीडियोस आते हैं दोस्तों वहां पर, बल्कि हमारे पेड मॉड्यूल्स हैं, आज भी भारत के मोस्ट कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव पेड मॉड्यूल्स, सिस्टमैटिकली कवरेज करते हैं पूरे जो जीएस को, एंड मेंटरिंग भी अब तो शामिल है। दोस्तों, मैं आपको इनवाइट करता हूं इस पूरी जर्नी में जो कि भारत के ग्रास रूट से क्रिएट कर रही है अब टॉपर्स।
हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज संकेत कुमार अजमेरा एंड आई हैव सिक्योर्ड ऑल इंडिया रैंक ऑफ 35 इन यूपीएससी सीएससी 2022 एंड टुडे आई विल बी शेयरिंग माय एसे राइटिंग स्ट्रेटजी फॉर सिविल सर्विसेज। आई थिंक द जनरल नोशन दैट पीपल हैव व्हेन दे आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर एसे राइटिंग इज दैट दे ट्राई टू कंसोलिडेट ऑल द नॉलेज दैट आई हैव गेन्ड फ्रॉम प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर द जनरल स्टडीज पेपर्स 1 to 4, बट आई वॉन्टेड टू डू समथिंग डिफरेंट प्राइमरली बिकॉज इफ एवरीबडी इज डूइंग द सेम थिंग देन आई वुड देन देर विल नॉट बी एनी रीजन फॉर द एग्जामिनेटर टू गिव एनीबडी मोर और लेस मार्क्स। सो आई डिलीनेटेड माई प्रिपरेशन फॉर एस ए फ्रॉम द जी एस प्रिपरेशन एंड आई रिलाइड ऑन माई हॉबी दैट इज बुक रीडिंग टू प्रिपेयर कॉन्टेंट फॉर माई एस ए। So basically what this has done is that as mentioned earlier, my content would be original and be very different from other people who have who are putting a lot of GS based content in their essays. And secondly, what it also did is that I used to be able to replicate in a very original manner about in the way that authors used to express their views in their books. So that also helped me to differentiate myself from the crowd, because I believe there is a trend going on in which various dimensions like social, political, geographical and historical dimensions are spelled out in the essay, which I think is a very linear fashion and does not create interest among the reader of the essay. So by reading a lot of books, I could learn how to present my arguments in a very flowy, non-linear kind of manner and not be very objective at the same time. And so this was about how I used to build content, and for this I used to hardly spend 15 minutes before sleeping every night to read any book, and I used to highlight in the book itself which were my notes for essay preparation that I used to refer before the essay exam. And secondly, I used to emphasize on the importance of brainstorming before attempting any essay. So given 1.5 hours for each essay, I used to spend the first 15 minutes not writing anything on the paper, but in the first 3 to 4 minutes, I used to select an essay. Then in the remaining 11 to 12 minutes, I used to brainstorm all the things that are required to fill a length of 11 to 12 pages. So I used to create headings, titles, and I also used to allocate the number of pages required under each title. So for example, there used to be a pre-introduction which would start by an anecdote, which used to be around 1 or 2 pages. Then I used to have a main introduction in which I used to explain my position on the essay, my understanding of the essay, so that the examiner will know which perspective that I'm talking about. And then I would also briefly summarize the essay that I'm going to write in the next 10 or 12 pages. Then after 2 pages of introduction, then I would go into the main body, and the main body would contain positive arguments, for example, in the first 4 pages, and negative examples in the next 4 pages. And in the final pages, I would have a conclusion that I used to draw from the arguments that I've stated in the last few pages. And finally, I would have a last final conclusion in which I used to quote a lot of references, and at the same time used to end it with a punchline or a poem. In one of my first attempts, I actually ended my essay with a poem, I think, which was greatly liked by the examiners, and I scored very well in my first attempt as well. But in the second attempt, there was a slight decrease in my marks, especially because one thing I did not mention here is that whenever we are allocating different sections in an essay, there needs to be a continuity, a flow that needs to be maintained between each section. So I believe that flow is the keyword in essay writing, and nothing gives you more marks than maintaining flow in this particular essay. And so I would like to request everyone to please focus on brainstorming एंड इवन वेन प्रिपरेशन इट इज़ नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट यू राइट 12 पेजेस ऑफ एन एसे फॉर ईच एसे, जस्ट वर्क ऑन दैट 15 और 20 मिनट्स ऑफ ब्रेन स्टॉर्मिंग दैट यू वुड डू बिफोर ईच एसे फॉर वेरियस फॉर ए वेराइटी ऑफ टॉपिक्स एंड देन ट्राई टू रेप्लीकेट इन अ फ्यू एसेज बिफोर यू राइट अ मेन एसे. And by this, I would like to thank the Delhi Knowledge Tank for helping me to express my views on essay writing strategy. And I believe this will help a lot of aspirants in the future appearing for the exam. Thank you very much.